Maraming salamat po. Magandang hapon po sa inyong lahat. Energy. Ang taas ng energy natin. Magandang hapon po sa inyong lahat. Okay, salamat po. So, ang gagawin ko po ngayon ay isi-share ko or ibabahagi ko sa inyo kung ano po ba itong mga modules na ginawa. Ang gagawin ko po ay titingnan natin yung iba-ibang components ng module at magpe-present po ako ng sample na ginawang PowerPoint ng CFA. And then later on, may challenge po tayo sa isa't isa. Okay, so, pisahan po natin. Kung titingnan po natin yung module, nakita nyo na po ba yung module? Pwede po natin pakilabas yung ating mga modules, okay? So, ako po ay si Pilar Romero. Ako po ay isang katikista. Dapat po ay i-introduce ako ni Annette at saka ni Ofin. Ang introduction nila sa akin ay isang katikista, nagmamahal sa mga katikista, nagmamahal sa simbahan. Sabi ko sa kanila, sabihin nyo din naman, nagmamahal ako sa asawa ko. Siyempre, kasi kailangan niya, no? Ako po ay may asawa, may tatlong anak. So, eto po, no? So, kung makikita po natin yung module, ang unang-unang po makikita natin ay yung mga objectives. Nung ginagawa po yung module, ang sabi po namin, talaga napakahalaga ng objectives. Kung tayo po ay nasa field ng education, alam po natin kung anong kahalagahan ng objectives. Di po ba ang sabi po nung isang ni Alice in Wonderland, natatandaan niyo po ba yung sabi ni Alice in Wonderland? Sabi niya, "If we do not know the way, any way will do." Eh, hindi po tayo pwedeng ganyan. Kung wala po tayong objectives, para po tayong headless chicken, no? We will just flap our wings, and we do not know kung saan po tayo pupunta. Now, saan po namin hinugot yung objectives? Alam niyo po, later mamaya, may papakita ko sa inyo yung interesting, no? Saan po namin hinugot ang objectives? Ito pong objectives ay binasi namin dun sa 5 specific objectives of catechesis that is found in the NCDP. So, tinignan po ang NCDP, tinignan yung 5 specific objectives, nandito po yan. So, I took the objectives in one of the modules in order to show you na may correspondence yung objectives dun po sa specific objectives ng NCDP. Okay. So, kunyari po, ito po yung sample natin. At the end of this module, the participants would, first, understand that the Paschal mystery of Christ, His passion, death, and resurrection brought salvation. Ito po ay ayon dun sa first objective ng catechesis. What is that? Developing understanding of the truths of faith. Okay? Kung titignan po natin yung pangalawang objective ng module, ng isang module, ito naman po ay nagko-correspond, it corresponds to the second specific objective of catechesis. What is that? Educate in the principles and practice of Catholic morality. Ang NCDP po, gumamit po ito ng salita tungkol dito. Ang tawag po ay para daw po magkaroon ng performative faith. Performative faith, no? So, yan po yung second. Kung titingnan po natin, respond to the call. To them, to bring Christ and His gospel of hope to people, especially in Asia. So, yan po yung tinatawag nating educate in the principles and practice of Catholic morality. Pangatlo po, yan. Ito naman po, the third objective in the module would correspond to the third specific objective in NCDP, ng catechesis. Instruct on how to pray and participate actively in the Eucharist. So, anong objective? Makikita po natin dyan, ano? The same words, commit to participate actively in the Eucharistic celebration as a manifestation of faith in Christ's presence and His gift of mission. Then, pang-apat po, ito po yung the fourth specific objective of catechesis po, sinasabi for the catechized to have a sense of belonging and committed service as active members in the church community. Nung una po, yung sa mga first module na ginawa, medyo yung, ito po yung ecclesial forming or community forming of aspect of catechesis, medyo hindi po nabigyang focus. We felt that it's important that this aspect of catechesis is emphasized in community forming, yung ecclesial forming. So ito po yung, draw strength from the Eucharist in fulfilling service as active members of the parish community. And finally, yung fifth po, Ito po yan, no? It satisfies the fifth specific objective, which is the double skill. Ano po yung double skill na tinatawag natin? For the catechized to incarnate their Christian faith in attitudes and values of daily life. That's the first skill. The second skill is interpret their daily life in the light of the gospel. So, ito pong ganitong correspondence between the objectives in the module and the specific objectives of catechesis in NCDP would be seen all throughout the modules. Okay? So, ang first, very important component po ng module are the objectives. They point the way to which we should go. Okay po? Okay. Second, okay, ito po yung magandang sinasabi ko. Sa bawat lesson po sa module, meron pong context. Now again, this is very important. NCDP would insist on context because according to NCDP, if we have no context, we have no hearers. We have no audience. Okay, now, ang isa pong hinugot kong konteksto, makikita natin sa module, ay yung SWS survey. Okay, nandiyan po sa module yan. According to the SWS survey, in terms of mass attendance, bumababa, nagdudwindle daw po yung mass attendance and the living off as genuine disciples. Okay, so yan po yung konteksto. Now, sa konteksto pong pinresent, hindi naman po lahat negative. There is light and there is shadow. So, ano po yung shadow? Ito nga daw po, bumababa daw po ang mass attendance. No? Ano naman po yung light? Pinresent din po dyan, no? The small percentage, even if it's a small percentage, instead of being a source of frustration, can become a source of light. Bakit? May kita po natin sa document, baka itong small percentage na to, yan ang nagpo-form ng isang inner concentric circle that we are going to see later. Okay? Now, ano pa po bang ibang konteksto? Kung titingnan po natin yung module ng kabataan, may konteksto po dyan. Anong magandang konteksto gamitin natin? Ano po ba ang mga kabataan natin ngayon in terms of the three L's? Tatlong L's. First L is lifestyle. Ano po ba ang lifestyle ng mga kabataan? Alam po natin, bilang katikista, dapat alam natin na ang mga kabataan mahilig po sa chill. Di ba? Pag medyo natatanong ka at taka, ano sasabihin? Chill lang tayo, chill. No? It's a parang kalma lang, no? Keep calm, kalma lang, chill, no? So, maaring ito po, we can interpret this as something that is negative kasi parang it may smack off nonchalance, no? Parang, pakialam, chill lang. Pero, if we look at the survey, another survey done by McCann Erickson on the youth all over the world, it shows that the youth, this is common among all the youth all over the world, has this desire for connectivity, for communication. So maganda pong pagtuunan yung communication as a positive aspect of the youth. Gusto nila laging kumonek. Okay, in terms of lifestyle. In terms of language naman po, napakakulay po ng lingwahe ng mga kabataan. No? Ano po yung mga example ng kanilang mga ginagamit na mga salita? Madalas natin naririnig, wow, grabe, intense! Diba, naririnig po ba niya, nyo yan sa mga kabataan? Grabe, intense! Or kung hindi intense, grabe, fierce. Ang fierce mo naman. No? Or, meron din silang tinatawag, ginamit nga nila Anet Kangina, buwis buhay. Ano? Ang sabi nga nila, kapag daw ang isang babae, nag-high heels, kahit magkadapa-dapa siya, ang tawag doon ay tiis ganda. No? Lahat ay titiisin para lang gumanda. No? Yan mga term nila, tiis ganda yan. No? Or, ito pa, magandang term, push mo yan, te. Diba? Pag medyo nakikita nila, ikaw ay medyo adamant over something, ano sabihin? Push mo yan, te. And, etong favorite pa nila, yung sign pong yan ay hindi number sign. Sa edad po natin, yan ang number sign. Sa edad nila, yan ay hashtag. Diba? Hashtag hugot. Ano ibig sabihin ng hashtag hugot? Pag ang isang bata po, ito po ay pag nagtuturo ako, no? At may tinanong ako at biglang nag-share. Ang sasabihin ng mga classmate, hashtag hugot. Ibig sabihin, may pinaghuhugutan, may pinagdadaanan. Marami po sa atin yung ganyan, di ba? May magbanggit lang ng isa. Bigla na magre-react. Bakit? Hashtag hugot. May pinaghuhugutan, may pinagdadaanan. Ito po ay mga expression ng kabataan na pwede po nating gamitin sa catechesis natin sa module. Buwis buhay. Eh, sino ba ang nagbuwis buhay? Di ba? Sino ba ang intense ang pagmamahal? Di po ba? Pwedeng-pwede nating magamit. We may look at these expressions as something we cannot relate to. We can always relate to them. Okay? So language and then longing. Okay. May kita po natin later on in the module that I will show you, these children, okay, they long for acceptance. Ay, yun nga po palang dialogue, no? Later, sasabihin ko yung dialogue. Binention ni Monsi, minaalala ko tungkol sa dialogue. They long for acceptance, but they also sometimes would want to be left alone. Yung pong mga may anak sa atin dito, na adolescent, nakaka-relate po tayo dyan, di ba? They want acceptance, but sometimes they want to be just left alone. Okay, and we have to be very sensitive about these things. Okay, now according to McCann Erickson, another thing, very important thing that these young people long for is, from the adults, is authenticity. They want authenticity, especially from us adults. Ayaw na ayaw daw po nila ang peke. No? So, isang challenge din sa atin yan, authenticity. Now, something they also long for dialogue. Alam niyo po, they long for dialogue, kaya lang minsan they are so frustrated. Why? Because instead of dialogue, ang natitira lang, daya. No? Nawawala yung totoong dialogue. Nadadaya sila. Why? You know, sometimes what they say is, okay, kunyari magbibigay ng time for dialogue, but actually when the adults dialogue, they don't really listen because while having dialogue, they are thinking of something else, and I am, as a parent, so guilty of this. So instead of dialogue, daya lang ang nangyayari. No? So, kaya na-frustrate itong mga bata. Okay? So, ito po yung masyado. How about, isinabi na po natin yung light. Okay? Next. According to the document, again still in the area of context, there are three concentric circle, okay, in Philippine society or in the church, okay. The inner core, this is the light. There is the inner core, the small circle. Sino po yung small circle na yan? These are the lay, the religious, and ordained, relatively small, yes, in number, but who live as disciples of Jesus and are actively involved in the life and mission of the church. Ito po yung maliit lang na circle. Okay, relatively small, no? But nevertheless, the number may be small, but the intensity is there. Okay? So, this is what we call the creative minority who become agents of evangelization. Okay? Ngayon, yung shadow, merong bigger circle. What is this bigger circle? Seasonal and occasionally involved Catholics. Yung mga season-season, di ba? Kung Christmas season, Advent season, or Lenten season, yaano, kung nakikita yung pagiging Katoliko, may dinagdag po din ako dyan, festival Catholics. Sino itong mga festival Catholics? Pag merong mga festival, di ba? Pistiamang Quiapo, Peña Francia, no? Santo Niño. Pag may festival, lumalabas ang pagiging Katoliko. Okay, that's the bigger circle. But the biggest outer circle is composed of seasonal or nominal Catholics. Okay, sa PCP 2, no, I think, meron din tinatawag na mga lapsed Catholics. No? So yun po yung pinakamalaking circle. Okay? So, you see, ito po yung konteksto na pinipresent. Okay? But what is beautiful in the document is that after the context, there is a synthesis. Meron pong synthesis, a sentence there. Okay? For example, dito po, after the context, sinasabi lahat yan, there is this statement that serves a synthesis. Ito po yun. Today, there is a shortage of hope in the world as perhaps never before in history. Now, hindi po natatapos sa synthesis. It provides a link to the second component, which is the Word of God or church teaching or liturgy. What is the link? Tingnan niyo po, ito po yung statement. And the message of hope is this. So, this there is a very smooth transitioning, okay, between the context and the Word of God. Now, this is something very important. Ang napapansin ko po, ako po ay nagtuturo sa USF, may hawak po ako mga religious education majors, no? Yung mga magiging teacher po ng religion, mga fourth year, third year, second year. Ang nakikita ko po sa mga ginagawa nilang learning plan is that ito po yung nawawala, yung transition. How does the experience connect with the Word of God or with the lesson? That is why this is very important. Okay, so makikita po natin yan sa document. Okay, so we're done with the second component. The first component is, what's the first component? O tingin sa kodigo. The first component is objectives. The second is context. Very good. And the third, we have the Word of God, the church teaching, and also drawing from liturgy. That's the third context. So, dito na po, feature ang Word of God. So, there is a biblical text, one, two, or three biblical texts that are presented. Okay. And what is good is that the biblical text is also given ample explanation. May explanation po yung biblical text, no? So, we will find a lot of wisdom, no, from the explanation that is given. Then, also, hindi lang po explanation. What the document does is to draw the doctrinal truth, the moral truth, and the truth about worship that is present in the biblical text, the church teaching, or liturgy. Now, you see, if this is the case, then it satisfies then the need for a systematic catechesis. Okay, NCDP is insistent on us coming up with a systematic catechesis. Systematic and integrated. And when we say systematic and integrated, dapat po ay present yung ating mahal na DMW. The doctrine, the moral, and the worship. So you see here, in the explanation of in the commentary about the biblical text and also the church teachings, there is some sort of a encapsulation. It encapsulates, no, the meaning of this text and puts them into a doctrinal, moral explanation and then truth about worship. So, ito po yung example which is there in the document. Okay? Later po, yung mga tanong natin if we have questions. Okay. Next. Yan. The third last component is the so-called faith response. Okay. So, in the faith response, there are a series of questions that engender a response from the audience, for the ones being catechized. So, again, if you look at the questions, again, they follow the DMW concept. Okay. So, the first question is about doctrine. There. The third question is about morals and the second. And the third question is about worship. So, we kind of go back to the objectives, which is also about the MW, which is reinforced in the content. And finally, which is the response? Okay, what kind of response do we want at three levels? At the level of knowledge, doctrine, at the level of affection, worship, and then at the level of action, which is the moral aspect. Okay, so if we put all of them together, then what we want to ensure is we come up with an integrated and systematic catechesis which is enshrined in the module. Okay po? Okay. Now, I will present naman po an example of the PowerPoint presentation that CFA made. Okay, and bibigyan din po kayo ng kopya nito. Okay, so eto po, Christ loves us. Okay, I think this is a module for the youth. Okay, so that's the title of the module. And then, Christ loves us, the Eucharist, a sacrament of love, a sign of unity, and bond of charity. So that's the complete title of the module, lesson one, module. Okay. So, context. What do we all hunger for? Diba? Ang tawag po natin dyan sa education, the field of education, this is inquiry arousal. No, we may make use of inquiry in order to get the attention, to engage the attention of our students. And naturally, lahat naman po tayo, all of us hunger for something. This is something that is true in all of us. Now, it starts with this because, again, I will invoke NCDP. According to NCDP, go where the students are. Go where the learners are. So we take into consideration, ano po ba ang konteksto nila? So we ask them, what do we all hunger for? Okay? Now, so, we all hunger first for love. Sino po ba dito? Who among us hunger for love? Si, konti lang po pala, no? Dapat, ibig sabihin po, lahat tayo ay punong-puno ng pagmamahal. Eh, dapat lang naman, di ba? Bilang katikista, dapat po talaga, ito, punong-puno tayo ng pagmamahal. Okay, we hunger. So, ibig po sabihin, hindi po totoo ito, kasi nakalagay po dito, we all hunger for love. Okay? Then, we also hunger for understanding. Okay, sino po sa atin? Hunger for understanding. Oh, father? Father po kayo? Ah, okay, father. Si father hungers for understanding. Okay. We all hunger for peace, especially in light of what happened recently, which really shattered, no, our very core, no, it shattered us to the core, really, no. And the more that we cry for and pray for peace, so we all hunger for peace. Alam niyo po ba sa mag-asawa that this is true? We hunger for peace, no, especially kapag ang mga anak mo ay maliliit pa, no. Peace is really what you want, no. But well, it's part, no, of growing up as a couple and growing up as a family, no, peace. Okay, pero later on naman po, pag kami ay empty nest na, no, humahanap naman po kami ng ingay. Kasi by that time po, pag empty nest na ang mag-asawa, it's either hindi na makasalita, hindi na rin makalakad, no? So nagtitingin na lang kami. Yun naman, sobrang peace. Okay, so we hunger for peace. We hunger for acceptance. Okay? Ang sinasabi po ba ni Maslow ay dapat sa edad natin ay nalampasan na natin ang need for acceptance. Hunger for acceptance, di ba? No, medyo iba na yung level natin in terms of Maslow's theory. Okay. We also hunger for purpose in life. I suppose lahat naman tayo already has a purpose in life. And we also hunger for justice. We hunger for unity. And finally, we hunger for companionship. Hindi ko na po tatanungin kung sino po ang nag-hunger for companionship. Baka po malagot ako bigla, no? We all hunger for companionship. Okay, so yan din po, konteksto pa po iyan, no? We all hunger. Okay, next. Again, context. The youth of today, this is from the module for the youth, okay? The youth of today often feel left out. Is this true? In a sense, no? They feel left out. They feel overlooked and abandoned. Okay, so in this particular scenario, where do they go? Some of them would take comfort, seek solace in drugs. Some would seek solace in their peers, kanilang mga barkada. And some, not some, but I think many of them would seek comfort in social media. Kasi po, social media gratifies their basic need for friends. Ang dami-dami po nilang friends, isn't it? Ang tawag po dyan sa ibang country, these are recyclable friends. No? Kasi pwede mong i-recycle yung mga kaibigan na yan, no? Or these are friends for convenience. Bakit convenience? Kasi gusto ko maraming friends, although friends ko lang sila sa Facebook, but I don't really know them, no? Friends for convenience. Okay. Barkada sa social media. Alam niyo po, if I want my children to go ballistics, kailangan mawalan kami ng internet. Pag nawalan po kami ng internet, they really go ballistics, no? Ganyan po yung characteristic na makinakatechize natin ngayon. Ang tawag natin sa kanila ay digital natives. Sila po ay digital natives. The digital natives were born with their umbilical cord connected to the computer. They live and breathe computer. Tayo po ay mga digital immigrants. Immigrants lang tayo. Some of us are digitally stupid. No? So, may mga iba talaga, hindi talaga kaya mag-digital. No? So can you just imagine? There is the so-called digital divide. Okay, the digital divide between the young people we catechize and us. Okay, which is one of the challenges in our mission, in our vocation, to try to, you know, if not eliminate, but you know, at least make the digital divide less noticeable. Okay? So social media. But positively, we also see that these young people are able to turn to their families. Okay, ito po ay isang napakaganda. Alam niyo po, in one of my discussions, one of the major courses that I handled last time is about family. These are composed of fourth year religious education majors, and I have about 10. Okay, among the 10, when we were sharing about the family, among the 10, there was only one, iisa lang po, ang walang hang up sa family. No? Iisa lang out of 10. Can you just imagine that? Yung 9, lahat may hang ups about family. So, this is the reality. There are still those who turn to their families. Kaya lang naman, baka when they turn to their families, the families are not there. Parang nung kanta, may kanta po nung araw na ganyan eh. Alam niyo po ba yung kantang yun? Lumang kanta na po ito, makaka-relate po sa akin dito ang mga seasoned catechists. No, seasoned is the euphemism for, alam na po natin yun, no? So, yung mga seasoned catechists, merong kanta na, I run to the door, but the door run away. So, I run to my family, but my family is not there. But good thing, there are still families who are there for their children. They are able to turn to their friends, and it's a good thing if their friends are really friends in the true sense of the word, who would care for them, no? Ngayon po, meron naman tinatawag na caring community. It's good if their friends are really a caring community, and they turn to this, the family and their friends for support. It would be good also if they can turn to the parish. In our campus ministry, in the university, and also our guidance office, meron small circles of caring community that the young people can always run to and turn to if they don't have any family to run to. Okay? So that is something, again, we are speaking of context. And some youth turn to the church, those who are very active in church, and some youth also turn to God. Okay? So, makita po natin dyan ang shadow, kanina, and then also light. Okay. So, here is some sort of a synthesis of the context. We hunger, this comes from CFC. Diba? Yung hunger na tinatawag na discussion of the Eucharist. We hunger for understanding, love, so on and so forth. But who gives us what we hunger for? It is Jesus Christ, who knows us perfectly from within. Okay. Kanginang umaga po, ang reading po natin is about, is a gospel natin, no? Ang ganda-ganda po ng homily, if I may just share, yung homily nung pare sa misa, sabi niya, why is it that when people are so happy, they close their eyes? Or if we see something that is so violent, we close our eyes. Because, sabi niya, we close our eyes because we are seeking the light from within. No, it's the light from within that gives us light. Unlike, di ba po, pag ngayon, ang dami nating light, no? Pinapawisan na nga po ako dahil sa light. No? Pero nakikita naman po natin ang isa-isa because of the light. But when, kung medyo malabo po ang paningin natin, we close our eyes and the light inside of us enlightens us. Yun, in order to see the beauty in life. Yun din daw po ang rason kapag ang dalawang nagmamahalan, kapag sila daw po ay magkikis, sila po ay nakapikit. Hindi daw po dahil ayaw nila makita ang mukha, no, ng kanilang nahalikan, but because they want to see the beauty of life as seen in the love that they share for one another. Besides the more practical reason na maduduling ka kapag hindi ka pumikit. Yun po yung practical, no? Pero yung theological po ay yan, no? Okay, anyway po. So, siyempre naman, nakaka-relate ako. Ewan ko lang po yung iba. Ay, hindi na mo. Hindi po nakaka-relate sila. Okay, in the Eucharist, okay, again, no, this is a, after the context, eto na po yung tinatawag nating the third component, which is the church teachings. Okay, and then drawing also from liturgy, and later on we would see that we will also draw from the Bible. Okay, so again, from CFC. Okay, and then here now are the texts from the Bible. One from Matthew. Okay, take and eat. This is my body, this is my blood, okay, of the covenant. And then after Matthew, again, we give another one from the Gospel of John. Father, may they be one as you and I are one. Kasi communion of love, di ba? Oneness. Okay. And then also again from John, a new commandment I give you, that you love one another as I have loved you. Now, after this, may mga explanations din po, again, taken from CFC. Okay. Then, also taken from the document itself, no? Yung Eucharist, source and goal of the church mission. So, again, this one, explanation of the biblical text. And, okay, so yun po, no? Biblical text, explanation, and then, that is the doctrine. Ito po yung moral aspect na tinatawag natin. Kanina yung doctrine, this is the moral aspect. In the Eucharist, we are transformed and are sent to transform others. So, this is the mission. Diba yung tinatawag na mission? Kanina, communion, ngayon naman ay mission. We are transformed and are sent to transform. Okay. By receiving the body and the blood of Christ, we become sharers in the divine life in an ever more adult and conscious way. This is drawn from the church teaching. Okay? And again, this is from Augustine, St. Augustine. Okay? You shall be changed into me. So, actually, it draws from the rich tradition of the church also. Ang sinasabi nga ni Monsi, we try to go back to these traditions because they enrich our ministry. Okay, and again, from the basic text of catechesis. Okay, and the Eucharistic IEC, basic text of IEC. Okay? Okay, again, from the basic text. Okay, again, oh, this is the epic, eto naman po sa liturgy. So, nasasatisfy na natin yung biblical, church teachings, and then liturgy. So this is from the consecratory epiclesis. Again, communion epiclesis. And we go back to the IEC document. So these are all inputs. Baka po, somehow, no, if you look at this, hindi ba parang, aren't we overwhelmed by this? No? Kaya nga po, one of the challenges that face us is we cascade them in such a way that they become meaningful and age and developmental appropriate. Okay, to the level of the people we catechize. Okay, so ito po yung, ay sorry, yan po yung ating mga basic text. Okay, sandali lang po. Sorry. Okay, ayan. Okay, so this is basically the summary in the document. Okay, so Christ loves us, He becomes intimate with us, He transforms us, He calls us to love others, And what is our response? So, you see, ito pong tatlong ito, this is some kind of an encapsulating what has been discussed, everything, no? So, we encapsulate them in terms that are easy to understand. Why is that necessary? According to NCDP, every time we teach, something must be committed to memory. Something must be committed to memory. Kasi ang point po ng NCDP, sometimes, no, they grow up, they take catechetical lessons or they study religion in school, but afterwards, they don't remember even anything. Okay, so something must be committed to memory. Bakit may committed to memory? Para po hindi committed ang kanilang memory, di ba? No, something must be committed to memory para hindi committed ang kanilang memory. They remember something. Okay, so these very short words are very easy to commit to their memory. Okay, so after they have committed this to memory, what is your response now? Ano ang response? Okay? Yan, committed to memory. Okay, our response. Okay. So these are the questions in the modules that would engender the response of the ones we are catechizing. In what ways can you, or pwede rin, in what ways will you, ma, para mas may dating, no? In what ways will you become an agent of love and a sign of unity in the home, community, and parish? We emphasize po the parish because we want the children, our student learners, catechized, to really feel a sense of belonging in the parish. Okay. Yun po, hindi na po magko-comment. Okay, next. What do you think will be the fruit of your fidelity to the Eucharistic life? And in what ways may you celebrate His presence? His pujan is Christ, no? Presence in your daily life. Ito na po yung two-way skill of incarnating the message in their daily life and in trying to see their daily life in the light of the gospel. So, for example, we ask them to come up with a pledge of commitment, no, or by frequent visits to the Blessed Sacrament. Okay, maganda po ang module, isn't it? Now, the question is, how do we use? Okay, how do we use? In the use of any module, any instructional material, whether it's a book, okay, we have to remember the word soar. Soar. Si soar. No? Ibang soar po ito, no? Hindi po si soar. Soar, S-O-A-R. Okay, what does the word soar stand for? No matter how good the material is, there is always the need for us to supplement. Okay, S. The first S is to supplement. Kasi po, in the process of contextualizing the document, there might be certain areas na na-overlook po, di ba? That is, sabi nga ni Monsi, it's a martyr document. It does not claim to be a perfect document. That's why we really need to supplement in terms of content and also in terms of context. While we say, for example, in terms of the youth, while we say that there are commonalities among young people nowadays, worldwide, and in the Philippines and in Asia, still, there is something unique about the Cebuano youth, the Manila youth, di ba? The Mindanao youth. So ito pong context na ito ay isa supplement po natin in order to adjust the flavor of the document to the people, the audience we are catechizing. Okay? So, yan po ang isang S, no? So, to adjust the flavor. Tama po ang flavor na pinag-uusapan natin dahil nagsaserve na po ng snacks. Okay? Napaka-contextualize, no? Nang dinidiscuss natin. Flavor. Okay. Then, the S also stands for segregate. It might be that one topic is too much for our audience. They might suffer from indigestion. At alam naman po natin ang nangyayari sa indigestion, di po ba? Pag may indigestion, hindi nakukuha ang nutrients, hindi pumupunta sa katawan, nilalabas lang lahat later. Either through dig high or dig low, no? Pwede sa taas or pwede sa baba. Now, we don't want our the people we are catechizing to suffer from indigestion. Therefore, pinag-uusapan pa rin nila yung dig high at dig low. Therefore, we segregate, we feed them with what they can digest. And there might be need for us to, no, chop-chop some of the topics if we feel that it's too much for the people we are catechizing. So that's S. Then O. O is order. So, you know, you might feel that the sequencing, there is a better sequencing that is appropriate to the kind of audience we are addressing. So, you are also somehow given the leeway to think of the best way by which you can order, okay, the sequencing of the document according to the particular context of your diocese. That's O. A, articulate. Ano daw po ang ibig sabihin ng articulate? Ayon po sa mga kabataan natin, articulate means maarti na, makulit pa, no? Articulate. Okay, so A is for articulate. What do we articulate? We articulate the document using our mother tongue. Anyway, no, even in our K-12, we are also going to that, no? The use of mother tongue. Why? According, again, I will invoke NCDP. According to NCDP, PCP2 in its discussion of renewed integral evangelization, ang sabi po niya dyan is, use the language that young people are comfortable with. Yung language na may tagos, may hugot, ika nga, no? And if that is the case, then we really need to articulate this document in the mother tongue. And finally, we need to revitalize. Okay, the document is a document. It does not tell you what strategies are you going to use. We need to come up with meaningful, up-to-date strategies in order to make it attractive to our young people. What am I saying? For example, if I were to discuss the context of the youth, I will not just be mouthing what kind of young people we are, I mean, we have, but I am going to show them a video that really captures the characteristics of young people nowadays. And what is this video? I'm gonna show you the video. Ito po ang pinapanood ng ating mga kabataan. Ito po ang kinakanta ng ating mga kabataan. At ito rin po ang description ng mga kabataan ngayon. Okay. Ay, yung sound po natin. Okay. Nandali lang po. Sir, okay na po yung sound natin. Pakitaan ko po kayo. Nanonood po ba kayo ng MTV? Hindi. Alam niyo po, pagkatikista tayo o religion teacher, panoorin po natin ng MTV kasi yan po ang pinapanood ng ating mga kabataan. Hindi po natin pwede sabihin sa kanila, naku, naku, huwag mong papanoorin yan. Bakit po napanood nyo na? Hindi. Basta feel ko lang, no? Hindi pwede. Pag sinabi natin, huwag mong panoorin kasi alam mo, no? Alam niyo po, habang inahanda po natin ng video, yung anak ko pong babae, siya po ay third year interior design na ngayon sa UST. Nung bata po siya, sabi niya, Mami, bili mo naman ako ng CD ng Pussycat Dolls. Meron pong isang grupo na Pussycat Dolls. No? Isa po doon ay Filipina. Si Nicole German po apelido, medyo mahirap i-pronounce, no? Si Nicole. Sabi niya, Mami, bili mo ako ng Pussycat Dolls. Sabi ko, sige anak, pero papakinggan ko muna. No? Sabi niya, sige. Aba, anong pinakinggan ko? Sus Mariosep. Ang unang napakinggan kong kanta, alam niyo po ko ano? Sabi niya, loosen up my buttons, baby. Sa Tagalog, buksan mo ang aking mga butones. No? Meron pang kanta doon na puro tut. Sabi ko, bakit ba puro tut itong kanta na to? Eh, kaya pala puro tut ay puro mura. Sabi ko, anak, sorry, I cannot buy you that CD because isang kanta lang ang gusto ko. Sabi niya, Mami, di siya light. Nag-light up yung face niya. May nagustuhan ka? Oo, anak. Anong kanta yun, Mami? When marimba music starts to play, dance with me. Siyempre naman, kasi panahon ko yun. No? Pero the other songs, my God, hindi po katanggap-tanggap. So, maigi din po na kung minsan-minsan naman, titingnan natin kung ano pinanonood ng ating mga anak, ng mga kabataan. No? Nagtsatsaga po akong pakinggan ang mga music nila para maging context sa catechesis. Okay. Okay na po tayo, sir? May sound na po? Okay na po ba? Sir? Okay. Ito po, sir.
Tama po.
Okay. Ang ano po lagi po, when we want no to come up with strategies like this, ang attitude dapat natin is, carry ko to. Caring, carry ko to. Yan expression din yan. Carry mo yan. Carry ko to. Okay, so, ito po yung sinasabi ko. Ito po ay the national anthem of young people nowadays. Taylor Swift. Kala ko kilala niyo pa si James Taylor. Yung mga medyo panahon natin. Taylor Swift po yan. No? Maganda po kasi message. Sometimes, we dismiss young people as trivial. Diba? There's nothing in my brain. I go on many dates. That's what people say. So, ano sasabihin ng mga kabataan sa atin? Shake it off. Because the haters are gonna hate, hate, hate. The players are gonna play, play, play. So, shake it off. No? But you could see in the video how talented young people are. No? Napaka-talented po nila. So, I think that is what we can harness. And I think this is a very good for me, ha? If I'm gonna talk of the context of young people, this, for me, is a very good context. Because they can relate to it. They know the song, they know Taylor Swift, and they know that young people like them are really talented. We just have to give them the break that they need. Okay? So, yan po yung tinatawag nating revitalize. Okay? Later on, meron po akong some questions that will somehow, you know, tickle our fancy, make us think. But before that, baka kayo naman po ang may tanong. Okay? So, we are going to entertain your question. And when I say we, hindi lang po ako, no? Marami po akong kasapakat, no? Dito sa modules na to, nandyan po ang si Fam, no? Si Annette at si Ofin. Nandyan din po si Mon, si Jerry. So, if there are questions that you want to put forward, might as well ask them now. May mic po ba tayo dyan sa baba? Ah, ito. May mic po. We have a mic here. In front, you may just approach the mic. Yung mga kumakain po, hindi pa po pwede magtanong, di ba? Because don't talk when the bus is in motion, di ba? Wala pong tanong? Kung wala pong tanong, ako naman po ang magtatanong. Okay po ba? Okay, so meron po tayong tanong, tatlong tanong. I have formulated three questions that we can brainstorm on. Okay, siguro po sa ating mga table na lang, no, we can brainstorm on these three questions. Now, this is brainstorming, no? Hindi po blame storming. Or minsan daw po, puro storming lang, nawawala ang brain. Okay, so brainstorming po tayo. So, three important questions. Okay, yan. First, the first question, I think this is pivotal, okay, in when it comes to the document, okay, what steps are we going to take to ensure that the modules are widely disseminated in our diocese? I think that's a concern, no? Second, what strategies are we going to use in order to ensure that the contents of the modules are effectively proclaimed, understood, appreciated, and medyo mahirap, lived out. Okay. And the third is, what are the logistical and human, syempre, we need logistics, no? What are the logistical and human resource support needed to effectively cascade the modules to the catechism? So, these are just three. Kung meron po ko pa kayo naisip ng mga katanungan, bahala po kayo. Anyway, kayo naman po ang sasagot. But basically, I think these three would address some of the concerns that we have regarding the dissemination of the modules. Okay po ba? Now, if there are no questions, no questions po, so these are the questions that we will more or less brainstorm on. You know, as we take our break and as we converse and interact with one another. So, maraming salamat po, and that is my sharing for you this afternoon.